Well, romantic comedies are generally set in the US, but the latest rom-com about to hit cinemas shows some love for the top end of Australia. Top End Wedding tells the story of Lauren and Ned, who face a rocky road on the way to pulling off their dream wedding in record time. Check it out.
I need to find my mum.
When you're hurting, where do you go looking?
Back home. Mum's from the Tiwi Islands, but I've never gone to Tiwi.
How about we just go up there? Look at where I am because of you. I'm in the top end of the country.
Weddings change people. Not just the bride and groom. Make this wedding romantic and you'll get Arnie back.
Marriage is a journey, and what better place to start that journey than right here?
Our home.
It's getting rave reviews. It's a gorgeous flick. Miranda Tapsell and Gwilym Lee are the stars, and they're on our couch. It's nice to see you two. Hey, before we get into your movie, I want to start with your own real-life rom-com that you seem to be living with your real-life husband, James Colley, who's a TV writer and also an author.
Yeah.
You guys met on Twitter.
We did. And don't worry, it's not like a catfish story or anything crazy like that. He just happened to be... he just happened to be friends of friends. Ah. So, I felt confident enough to sort of say hi and...
You liked what he did with 140 characters.
I did.
But by the sounds of it, because I was watching this whole conversation play out between friends of yours, and he loved you for a really long time, and when you started following him on Twitter, he just... his world just...
Yes.
Blew up.
But he keeps telling people the other way around. They're like, oh, no, she made the first move, but everyone goes, no, actually, James, the story. And so that's why they shared it all on Twitter and made fun of him, but which I was really glad about. And, yes, we had a beautiful, beautiful ceremony with lots of our dear friends and family. I loved that it was something that it was our choice. It wasn't that we felt something society forced us to do. We just really cared deeply about one another.
So you're all over weddings that prepared you for this for this movie?
Oh yeah, I wouldn't recommend like writing a feature film and making it at the same time as planning a wedding, because he was sort of calling me from isolated parts of the Northern Territory, going, "Do you want a cheesecake?" And I said, "Yes, one with cheese, not a cheesecake." We were having to yell that loud because I was only on two bars. So yeah, I'm really glad that we were able to pull both of them off.
Was that a rehearsal?
It was a rehearsal, yes.
Because you actually came up with the concept for Top End Wedding as well. Like, you're not just starring in it, you were behind the story and the idea.
Yes, because I grew up in the NT, I grew up in Kakadu, I've got family on Tiwi, and I'm just so proud of coming from there. I took it for granted growing up because my whole life consisted of bushwalking and camping, and it became tedious when I was a teenager. And I look back at it now and seeing the territory through new eyes, particularly Gwilym's, meant a lot to me because I thought, no, this is something I really should be embracing.
Did your own wedding kind of help feed into the top? Because I saw the film last week, it's beautiful, but everything goes wrong, doesn't it? Everything
that can
possibly go wrong does go wrong. Oh. They're true life disasters.
For sure. And it's one of those crazy things where you've kind of got to think about everyone, but you've also got to think about what you want. It's such a crazy dynamic.
And Gwilym, how does a Welshman find himself working in the top end of Australia?
Oh, it's a privilege being up there. In the trailer, you hear the character say, "Look at where I am because of you." I'm in the top end of the country, and I feel exactly the same from around it. So grateful to have had the opportunity to get up and see that part of the world, because you know I didn't know much about it, but we were talking before, it's a spiritual place.
It really is, really. And it struck me when I first visited the Northern Territory, particularly around Kakadu, just how the overwhelming kind of spiritualness of the place was amazing. It is like a little bit of a love letter to the top end as well. Have you seen the unofficial Northern Territory slogan that's getting around? See you in the NT.
Oh, yes.
I think this might do a bit more for the Northern Territory than
I think so too.
I've got a few souvenirs.
I'll lift the level of conversation a little from that. Well, without the curly wig, people might not recognise it. You played Brian May in Bohemian Rhapsody.
I did.
What's the reaction to that been like for you?
It's been amazing. I mean, we all had the most incredible time doing that and kind of living our dreams of being pretending to be rock stars, but we had no idea that it was going to be received in the way that it has, and we're thrilled. It's quite difficult to take stock of it at the moment because it all feels quite recent, but I think we'll look back at it in a few years' time and kind of pinch ourselves.
It was crazy to actually... I've never had a friend, like, on the Oscars red carpet, so it was quite bizarre to see your Instagram and go, oh, I know that dude. Like...
It's a bit like being in Madame Two Swords. Everywhere you looked was just another famous person.
Yeah. Well, you speak of the US. The response when this film showed at Sundance was so fantastic. Is this the kind of film that could go international?
I was so blown away with how a lot of Americans responded to it, because I thought maybe it might be a little bit too niche for them, that the humour might
just
be...
They don't really get Aussie humour, do they?
Yeah, that's a bit quirky.
Yeah.
But it just got huge laughs in the theatres we were sitting in, and I just couldn't believe that... they just seemed, it just really translated. People found many parallels, even though they hadn't been to Australia before. They understood the weddings and family and a sense of belonging. I was really touched by that. And so
Variety, the Showbiz Bible, what did they say?
This is a wedding you must RSVP to. I don't know if you read the reviews or not, because it might be scary one way or another, but people are just going gaga.
I'm so glad.
It's a great film. I can say it is magic and so original as well, which is what I loved about it. It's something that's just never been done before. It's not preachy, it's not pretentious, it's just a fantastic film exposing this beautiful world, and I loved it. I give it 4 stars.
Excellent.
Congratulations, you two. Top End Wedding lands in cinemas on May the 2nd. Please thank Miranda and Gwilym for dropping by.
Thank you so much.